night said they were doing a great job, but this is kind of a controversial time for them. There were three officers that were suspended last week. Can you comment that at all?
We have 720 police officers in the Rochester Police Department. You had three people that have been suspended. And they're being held accountable for acting outside of protocol. You cannot judge an entire police department by the action of three officers. And so while I also talked about today the fact that we are doing a good job, I also said we're holding people accountable when they do not do what they're supposed to do, which is aligned with our protocols. And so I think that that's very important to know.
Mayor, you talked a lot about
your opponents say that you still have not done enough for poverty. What do you say to refute those claims?
I think that if you listen to the speech tonight, we've done a lot for the people of our city, and we will continue to do a lot for the people of our city. When you think about Kiva, you talk to those individuals. Go to YAMTEP and talk to the individuals that have gotten jobs, or OTR, individuals that have been put to work and that are taking care of their families because of the great work that me and my team have done on behalf of the citizens of Rochester. Those are not my numbers. When you think about the fact that unemployment in our city have gone from 9% to 6%, that's not my number. That's the Department of Labor Statistics number. That is what I talk about today. That's what we're so excited about. And we will continue to be excited about the great work that we're doing here in our community.
Mayor, you talked a lot about your accomplishments or what you feel your accomplishments were over the last few years. What about you didn't talk a lot about what's kind of come up in the next year, assuming you get reelected. I mean, are there some things you want to mention that initiatives, things like that?
We talked about working with the school district and really, building community schools and doing that as it pertains to our education. We will continue to work with our community partners to bring jobs into our community and to build businesses. Right now, you have a number of companies that are looking at Rochester, and we're working with them to make sure that, that they have a home here and that they know that they have a home here. And we will continue to improve on our public safety initiatives. We talked about the fact that now we're looking for, precincts in the neighborhoods as well. We will continue to do land banking and to make sure that we're building upon the success that we've already had. The thing about it is that we're going in the right direction. We're building off of what we have done. We have reignited the city by working together, and we will continue to spread that light well into the future.
That $30,000 job figure just doesn't add up in a community that has seen rising poverty, has high unemployment in some neighborhoods. Do you know of those 30,000, how many are actually new jobs created under your term?
It's about 8,000 new jobs, 22,000 jobs, I believe, was retained. But those are not my statistics. Those are not the City of Rochester statistics. Those are the Labor Department statistics. My opponents want to talk about statistics from like 2015. It's 2017. They want to talk about an average from 2011 to 2015 from a no-name. Source. We're talking about from the Labor Department, the numbers that we're quoting as it pertains to our unemployment numbers, as it pertains to the jobs that we have been able to retain. And so that's what nationally is quoted, and that's what we will continue to quote. Those are not Lovely Warren numbers. Those are the numbers that the Labor Department has given us.
We talked tonight about the strides we're making with education in the city, but the graduation rate in Rochester still remains low. Can you speak to that at all?
Well, the graduation rate may remain, it's not where we want it to be, but it's better than it was. And I think that what we have to do as a community is stop looking at the negative and stop looking at the glass as half empty and look at it as half full. When you look at the progress and the fact that we are moving in the right direction, you could tell me that if we were going backwards. The fact of the matter is we're going forward. All of our numbers are improving, and that's something that we will continue to be proud of. No one can take that away from this administration. When you look at it across the board, whether you're talking about crime numbers, whether you're talking about what's happening around education, whether you're talking about jobs and improvement and safer and more vibrant neighborhoods, those are numbers that are real, not my numbers. These are numbers that are nationally known, and that's what I appreciate because it comes from somewhere else and not necessarily me.
your opponents have also said you're taking credit for things that are already in the pipeline from other previous mayors. What do you have to say about that?
Mayors build upon what other mayors have done. But when I talk about the Office of Strategic Initiatives, those are all programs that I started. When I talk about in development in Hudson Avenue, in East Main Street, those are initiatives that I started. When I talk about the Inner Loop, that is an initiative that I got funding for. And so my opponents will say what they want, but the facts speak for themselves. You cannot take away the great work that we have done in this administration. And let me tell you something. And let me tell you what's the difference between me and my opponents. Because when I ran for office, I didn't deny Tom Richards his due. I supported the work that he did. I was on city council as city council president. I had a different vision for our city. So this is not about my opponents. This is about the citizens of Rochester. It was about the citizens of Rochester 4 years ago, and it's about the citizens of Rochester right now.
You proposed a receivership district last fall. Where are we with that right now?
I talked to the superintendent. I talked to also the commissioner of education, and they told me that we would need state legislation to do it. But we have a new superintendent that I'm working well with. We've talked about the issues that are plaguing our district, and we talked about working together, starting with school number 17, working on school number 33, working with East High, and other things like that. This is about partnership. No one person can do it by themselves. We have to do it by working together.
You talked about the precincts a little bit a few moments ago in neighborhoods. Do we have specific locations for those yet?
No, we're working on that right now.